my name is Anuradha. I'm one of the directors of Estrella Professional. So the name of our company is Sayona Cosmetics, and today we've unveiled our first professional skincare brand, which is called Estrella Professional. Estrella has three brands under it with different regimens, different price points and different benefits, and each of them is exclusively made for Indian skin type. We've also brought in global technologies and surprisingly available at a very, very affordable price. So the product range is from X-Pro C to Intenso, Lumians, and finally Clarissa. Each of them has their own distinct benefits and advantages. Today we've chosen Music Academy for the launch because we have a crowd from all of Chennai, where we've invited invited aestheticians, invited salon owners, large chains, beauticians, etc., to attend this conference. We've just finished with the first part of the seminar, where we've done a detailed demonstration of Intenso, which is our flagship lightening product. We've also shown a demonstration of a Lumians hand spa, hand and leg spa, which is a need that each and every girl today has felt, because they wear short dresses and they wear sleeveless and they want clean, neat arms. So all these products are very centered and centric towards what a consumer really needs, because all these have been developed after a lot of research. We have global tie-ups with laboratories in Europe and other parts of the world. What we're going to do in the second part of the session today is something that all the beauticians are waiting for. That's going to be a session with a celebrity makeup artist from Mumbai. Her name is Aisha Wadiwala. She has been responsible for many looks for stars like Shah Rukh, Salman, Minisha Lamba. She's done several television commercials. She also assists the senior most makeup artists in the fraternity in the big shoots. She's a regular at the Lakme Fashion Week, etc. She really relates with Estrella because she also believes in, you know, bringing out the beauty in an inner person, and our philosophy ties back with what she believes in, which is beauty beyond the obvious. She is going to be doing a session where she's going to be demonstrating three different looks. So she will show a North Indian bride, a South Indian bride, and a Catholic bride, and how she's chosen different skin tones, different age groups, and different kind of features, and she will enhance those features with the use of makeup. In the previous session, she also showed us how the different products that she has used is going to prepare the skin as a lovely base. So we look forward to that session, and we look forward to the salons giving us a very positive feedback about our products. Thank you. See, the first session was very encouraging because we saw a lot of salons. See, the biggest point that the people have liked about it is that it is a very premium product. It can be compared to the most innovative imported products that are available today in the market. So to that extent, if you say Intenso, it's pricing, or the way it's packaged, or the fragrance, the texture, everything is extremely international because it is made using international formulations. Despite that, the price is extremely affordable. The units are sold in packs which are very affordable by the salon. So the salons have been very positive about it. We also brought up some techniques which salons have come up and told us, which are, you know, they've been facing a problem with. For example, they have to buy a different regimen for each of the class of facials that they buy. So what we have done is we've considered an open architecture technology, wherein they just buy one set of a cleanser regimen, and then they can combine that with all the other three brands, that is Intenso, Lumians, Clarissa. This is first of its kind. It's innovative, and the parlors have really liked it. We also had a brief chat with them informally over lunch, and a lot of them have expressed their desire to try it out immediately. They're all going to be carrying back a few gifts with them which have the products, but they've shown an extreme keenness in understanding a little more and trying this out with their clients, which I think is very positive for a new brand.
So is this available only in the salons, or are there other?
Yes, this is a professional product. So Estrella Professional, professional means it is to be used only by skilled experts and aestheticians, which means it is going to be used and administered only by salon owners, by the salon aestheticians. So for example, you know, I would not be able to do a facial on myself as effectively as someone who can do it on me from the salon. So it needs to be administered in a manner in which it is effective, which is why it is going to be available only in the salon. The next step, which is already already been implemented to some extent is an intensive training program for all the beauticians, who we call aestheticians, who are going to be trained on how the product is supposed to be used to make it efficacious, what is the kind of massage, what is the kind of serum application, what is the order, things like that. So training is the second part.
So the launch is happening only in Chennai, or the
Yes.
products are already being introduced?
No, the launch is beginning in Chennai today. So we've already done a press launch where we've introduced it. This is the second event which we are doing in Music Academy for all the community, which is the trade. Because at the end of the day, the people who are going to be using my products are the salon community. So today the launch event is for the salons, and from tomorrow we will start the dispatch and invoicing. So it's going to be available in the salons very shortly. I mean,
you
a lot of them have.
The other cities also, have
yes, seen? Absolutely. The plan is to scale this up to an all India kind of a level,
so
then take it from there. See, training,
training
we are not going to be doing in this fashion. Training is going to be more personalized. So we will be taking areas and clusters and getting people together and giving them a product specific training so that it's more useful, because a lot of stuff that we showed today is things that they might know. But what we want to also bring in is best practices, etiquette, salon profitability and things like that. So these are going to be different modules which will be done over a span of, a couple of weeks, a couple of months from here on. And it'll be done in smaller sections. It will not be such a grand thing, because we want a lot of one-on-one interaction. We want to interact with them, speak with them, understand their needs, etc.
So is there any consultation that is being provided even for the users who
For the customers. No, the customers, yes, the trainers, the people who are going to be, the training team that we have is going to explain to the aesthetician or the beautician about how she's supposed to tell the client about the benefits of the product and how she's supposed to choose which product she should use on which customer. Once the customer has done the facial, then she will be able to see the results, and then we will also take it up further with what are the maintenance things that she can do. So there will be training to that.
So
thank you. I'd now call upon Aisha. I'll just give you a preview of why we came upon with the bridal look as a seminar option today. We've had various beauticians and various people from different kinds of salons across Bombay, Delhi, Bangalore, Chennai give us this feedback during our research that sometimes the bridal looks becomes extremely plain, and they're very oft-repeated looks. There is no creativity. They try and look, a lot of times the brides bring a particular magazine and say, I want the Kareena look, I want the Karishma look. So we felt that with the RD season coming to an end and the bridal season beginning, it is very apt that we get somebody who is an expert at it and who will be able to demonstrate different kinds of looks. So I will leave the technical aspects to Aisha. But look out for some perfect techniques which she will use. She will even demonstrate it to you about how the brow needs to be done, how eyes can be accentuated, how a similar look can be used for different functions like mehndi, sangeet, cocktail, etc. So I really hope all of you benefit from it today. I'll hand it over to Aisha.
Come. The facial was done. So I'll be showing the Hindu bride on her, which is my first look. And the first look I'll be showing you from, because we have a time constraint, so the first look I'll be doing from the base to how the contouring will be done, to the eyebrows, to eye makeup, to lipstick, to everything. But then the second and the third look, which is the Catholic and the South Indian bride, I have already done their base, so that we'll directly proceed to eye makeup and other techniques. So I have since her face was clean because of the facial, I have just wiped it with the Estrella toner ones, and now I'm applying a primer. You guys are aware what a primer does, right? Basically, it is a barrier between makeup and skin. So it's a very important makeup tool, because it prevents the color pigments which are present in the foundation to go and touch your virgin skin. Number two, it creates a very nice base for your makeup foundation to glide on. It prevents 24-hour hydration, so your makeup doesn't look cakey or patchy after 2-3 hours. And the primers I use also have an SPF in case you're doing a Hindu bride who's having an afternoon function. So it also gives her skin the sunscreen protection. The most important step is to identify the right skin tone, which is really important because if the skin color goes wrong, the makeup looks chalky, it makes the person look dark. So a lot of makeup artists, they think that if a person needs to look brighter and fairer, you need to use a lighter color foundation, but that will not make her look brighter, it will make her look grey, because according to the color theory, dark plus white becomes grey. So you basically have to use a skin tone which is very, very close to a natural skin tone, and you can probably go half a shade lighter, but only on the center portion to give her the lighter, fairer look, but at the same time, she doesn't look chalky. So I'm trying to figure out which is the right color for her skin tone. So I'm trying it on her forehead. Best way to identify right color is to just dab and blend. And if it looks patchy, like if you guys can see, this looks patchy. So that means that this is not the right color for her. So this is her right color. So it's very important before you start makeup to identify the person's skin tone, rather than just taking a color which you think is right. Because sometimes we assume people have a skin tone which we think is the shade matching to the shade we have in our palette, but unless you try it, you can't come to know. And the best place to try it is either the forehead or the jawline. Okay, I'm using a technique of foundation application called the base layering. What happens is when you use a sponge or you use hand, you tend to take a lot of foundation and put it on the face, and then it becomes a little too much. So with the base layering technique, what happens is you can put as much as required. So you're not putting, because according to me, makeup is just meant to enhance what you have and not be like a mask. So I'm using a base layering technique with a foundation brush, layer of base, and then you can build up your coverage layer by layer. You can go up to 8 layers to give a really nice and dramatic look. For her skin, this is the first layer I have done and I've used very little. So eventually using the same amount of product you use once, but like this you can build up the base and it looks like it's your skin. It looks very close to your skin because it blends so well. It doesn't look like a mask. So now I'm starting with the second layer. And another very important technique to remember is that our face is not flat. Our face is 3D. Okay? So if you see a person without makeup also, so their face is only this portion reflects light and this portion is always having a shadow. So this is the portion that reflects light is supposed to be highlighted, and the portion that is showing the shadow supposed to be contoured and should be dark. So if you put like an even layer all over your face, it becomes flat and it looks chubby. That is the reason a lot of people who wear makeup start looking round after wearing makeup. So when you're putting foundation, more consistency and more of the product should be deposited on the center of your face, and only the remaining should be just spread towards the outside. So I've done with like 5 layers. This is going to give a, because for a bridal you need it to look a little more dramatic. If it's a party wear, you can stop on 3 layers. If you're doing a bride, you can go up to. Yes. No, that's what I'm going to come to. I prefer doing the base and then doing the concealer, because what happens is if the concealing is done before the base, the base wipes off the concealer. So when I do it, you will know the difference. See, the thing is, I use these thick concealing base palettes, so it already gives you good enough concealing. So only what is required has to be concealed. If you start concealing before using a base, you will use over concealer, which is not required. And then the whole look looks very artificial and plastic. Almost done with the base. And now what I'm doing is, this is a slight trick, because in South and everywhere universally in India, people are obsessed with fair skin. So if you want to make a bride look a little lighter, I don't prefer making someone who's dark, like totally light, but to give her a little brightness on her face, what you can do is you can go one shade lighter than her original skin tone, what you've used on her face, and just do the T-zone and the cheekbone. Okay, just for the benefit of people who want some Tamil translation, I'm going to attempt a little. Please cooperate. So, இப்போ என்ன சொன்னாங்கன்னா நிறைய நம்ம சவுத்தில் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா கொஞ்சம் டார்க்காக இருப்பாங்க, நிறைய டார்க் ஸ்கின் டோன்ஸ் இருப்பாங்க, விச் இஸ் ஆல்சோ நைஸ், ஹெல்தி நைஸ் டார்க் ஸ்கின். பட் சம் ஆஃப் தெம் ஆல்சோ வாண்ட் தட் ஆன் திஸ் பர்டிகுலர் டே த ஸ்கின் ஷுட் லுக் லைட், இட் ஷுட் யூனோ ரேடியேட் லாட் ஆஃப் ஃபோட்டோகிராஃப்ஸ் அண்ட் ஸ்டப் லைக் தட். ஸோ வாட் ஐஷாஸ் ரெக்கமெண்டேஷன் இஸ் தட் யூஸ் ஒன் டோன் விச் இஸ் லைட்டர் தென் ஹர் ஆக்சுவல் ஸ்கின் டோன் அண்ட் யூஸ் இட் ஓன்லி ஆன் த டீ ஜோன்
அண்ட் த சீக்
போன்ஸ் ஸோ தட் இட் ஆக்சுவென்சுவேட்ஸ் தோஸ் ஃபீச்சர்ஸ். So, do the T-zone and the cheek zone, the cheek area la mattum oru shade lighter use panni and the areas mattum konjam accentuate pandra mari konjam features nalla edupa vara madri panna solirukanga.
So basically I just put the lighter color on this portion, that also not the entire forehead, on the center of the forehead, on the nose bridge, and a little on her cheek bone, and a little bit of that you can add to her cheek. So it will already create a three-dimensional look and it will give her a brighter look. But she has a beautiful dusky skin, so I'm not going to make her white. I don't believe in that. Okay. And you have something which is called a buffer brush. So this is very good to blend the foundation into your skin and give a very even and natural look. So I'm just going to go lightly on top of it with a buffer brush. Once party makeup, and they don't need a heavy base, because a lot of people say that we want makeup but we want to look natural. So you can just use this buffer brush, just skip and just take the base very lightly and just put a moisturizer or primer on the skin and buff it. It will look naturally glowing, it will not even look like they're wearing a brush.
So நிறைய பேர் வந்து பார்ட்டி லுக்ஸ் அந்த மாதிரி போகும்போது எனக்கு ரொம்ப ஹெவி மேக்கப் வேண்டாம், பட் ஐ ஸ்டில் வாண்ட் ஸ்கின் வந்து கொஞ்சம் க்ளோ பண்ணணும், நல்ல நேச்சுரலாக இருக்கிற மாதிரி இருக்கணும் அப்படின்னு சொல்லும்போது இந்த பஃபர் ப்ரஷ் யூஸ் பண்ணி யூஸ் ஃபவுண்டேஷன் எடுத்துகிட்டு ஜஸ்ட் யூஸ் த ஆன் த மெயின் ஏரியாஸ் தட் இப்போ காமிச்ச மாதிரி, தட் மேக் ஷோர் தட் யூ லுக் நேச்சுரலாக இருக்கும் ஸ்கின், ரொம்ப மேக்கப் போட்ட மாதிரி ரொம்ப ஹெவி லுக் கொடுக்காது.
And because I think someone out there was asking about it. See, now that the base is done, I exactly know what is required to be concealed. What is the job that the base has not been able to do. Because otherwise, if you see her bare skin, there are a lot of things you'll be like, this has to be concealed, this has to be concealed. But once the base is done, you exactly know, like in her case, everything is beautifully concealed, but she just needs a little bit of under eye. So only for that, if I would have done concealer everywhere and then done a base, it would automatically look cakey. So that is the reason my way of doing it is, and which I also advise and it works for people, is do concealing after using the base.
நிறைய பேர் என்ன பண்ணுவாங்க, கன்சீலர் வந்து ஃபர்ஸ்ட் நிறைய இடத்துல அண்டர் ஐ பிளமிஷஸ் இருக்கிற இடத்துல ஃபுல்லாக யூஸ் பண்ணி ரொம்ப கேக்கி லுக் வந்துடும். அது ஃபுல்லாக போட்டிங்கன்னா கேக்கி, ஐம் ஷுர் யூ ஆல் நோ, விச் இஸ் பேசிக்லி யூ ஸ்டார்ட் கொஞ்ச நேரம் ஆகி ஸ்வெட் லைன்ஸ் எல்லாம் வந்ததுக்கப்புறம் ஃப்ளேக்கி ஒரு மாதிரி ஒரு லேயர் லேயராக வர மாதிரி இருக்கும். ஸோ வாட் ஐஷா இஸ் சஜஸ்டிங் இஸ் தட் அந்த ஏரியாஸ்க்கு மட்டும் வேர் உங்களுக்கு தேவை இருக்கோ அங்கே மட்டும் கன்சீலர் எண்டில் போட்டு ஸ்கின் இன்னும் கொஞ்சம் ஈவன் ஆகிறதுக்காக திஸ் இஸ் த நெக்ஸ்ட் ஸ்டெப் தட் ஷீ இஸ் சஜஸ்டிங்.
So what I'm doing is I'm taking the concealer, and this is a concealer brush. You get a flat one, but this is better because it's very soft for the under eye and it doesn't get into the lines, so it blends very well. So it's a smaller miniature of a buffer brush, it's called a concealer brush. Some people have very bad dark circles where a normal concealer doesn't work. So depending on the dark circles, you can mix a little red, orange or pink, depending on that, in your concealer and concealer. Like, she doesn't have much dark circles, but just to give a demo, concealing foundations and a creamy blush on also you can use. There should not be any sheen in it. There shouldn't be any glitter particles in it. You can even use a matte red lipstick or an orange lipstick. If someone has very black dark circles, you can mix a little orange lipstick into your concealer and then conceal. For her, I'm using a little peachy pink, and I'm mixing it with the concealer I was using.
நிறைய டார்க் சர்க்கிள்ஸ் இருந்தது, ரொம்ப பிளாக்காக ரொம்ப க்ரீமி ஸ்கின் காமிச்சாங்க, க்ரீமி கன்சீலர் ஒன்று. அந்த க்ரீமி கன்சீலர் கேன் பி மிக்ஸ்ட் வித் இந்த இப்போ யூஸ் பண்ணுற கன்சீலர் கூட மிக்ஸ் பண்ணி, சில டைம் ரொம்ப டார்க்காக இருந்தால் யூ கேன் ஈவன் மிக்ஸ் இட் வித் கொஞ்சம் லைட்டர் ஷேட் ஆஃப் லிப்ஸ்டிக் லைக் ரெட் ஆர் ஆரேஞ்ச் தட் ஷீ சஜஸ்டட். திஸ் பர்டிகுலர் லேடி டசன்ட் ஹேவ் ரொம்ப டார்க் சர்க்கிள்ஸ் இல்லை அவங்களுக்கு, பட் இந்த ஏரியாவில் கொஞ்சம் ஃபைன் லைன்ஸ் இதெல்லாம் அப்படி கவர் பண்ணுற மாதிரி.
நான் யூஸிங் எல்லோ பவுடர், to pack this foundation. A lot of people use compact and different color loose powders. You can do that, but then you have to keep a range of powders. But I prefer using a yellow powder, which is very translucent. It doesn't disturb the color that you've created. So in case with loose powders, you can go wrong if you take a darker or a lighter color by mistake. So you disturb the base you've created. But if you take a yellow powder, it doesn't disturb the base you've created. And it locks and seals the foundation completely into. When you're starting the powder, always start with under eye. Because what happens is, the under eye lines crease first. So after the concealer is over, first pack the under eye.
Or a full range of compacts nariye bridal artists paathirukke, they have a very wide range of in the shade nariye shade vechirupanga. So Aisha's suggestion is that she uses a translucent yellow powder nu solittu adu vandu any neenga endha base use pannirkingalo adu mela idu potanalo idu vandu nalla blend aidum. Ipo pathingana avanga actually use panna concealer shades and foundation shades versus the yellow powder shade avanga use pandra shade ku actually nariya difference irukku, but adu blend pannumbodhu pathingana nalla it's cleanly blended.
And one more reason why a yellow powder is very good for Indian skin tones is because you guys must be aware of undertones. We all have some undertones. The makeup artists know about it. Most 90% Indians have a yellow undertone. Even though you're fair, she, her, me, all of us mostly, only 10% Kashmiris, North Indians might have a pink undertone. Even Punjabis to a bigger extent have a yellow undertone. Very few have a pink. European people have a pink undertone. So yellow powder works with all the foundations. And the way I'm doing this is, I'm not just swiping it off because I don't want to remove whatever I applied. So I'm just sealing it by just going dab. Actually, this tip of yellow powder I've learned from a very famous actress called Kajol. I've done her makeup for Whirlpool. And she told me how her skin was always going wrong with different color. Every makeup artist would try a different compact on her. And then she found this yellow powder and she stuck to it. But she still uses it.
எல்லாரும் வேர்ல் பூல் ஆட் பார்த்துருப்போம். காஜோல் வந்திருக்காங்க அண்ட் அவங்களோட சீரீஸ் ஆஃப் ஆட்ஸில் ஷீ இஸ் அ டஸ்கி ஸ்கின் டோன், வி ஆல் நோ தட். ஸோ நிறைய ஆர்டிஸ்ட் வந்து ஐவன் ஐவ் சீன் இன் லாட் ஆஃப் ஹர் மூவிஸ், இன் கப்பிள் ஆஃப் ஹர் ஆட்ஸ், ஒரு மாதிரி கொஞ்சம் டார்க்காக இருக்கும், அப்புறம் கொஞ்சம் லைட் காமிக்கும், சிலதில் அவங்கள ரொம்ப ஃபேராக காமிக்கும், பட் த ரிமைனிங் பார்ட் ஆஃப் அ பாடி வில் லுக் அ லிட்டில் டிஃப்ரெண்ட். ஸோ ஐ திங்க் இந்த லாஸ்ட் கப்பல் ஆஃப் இயர்ஸில் அவங்க நிறைய சீனியர் ஆர்டிஸ்ட் கூட ஒர்க் பண்ணி ஐஷாஸ் டன் தட் ஷூட் வித் ஃபோர் வேர்ல் பூல். She also suggested that, you know, this yellow powder can be used very effectively. We just saw the way it's dabbed in, it's just gone into her skin. So the way skin could have, it doesn't look like she's wearing too much load on her skin at all.
Okay, now I'm doing, if you realize, I haven't put any concealer or anything on her eyes. Because I've been even doing everything and then starting the eyes. So I'm doing the same concealer what I use as a base, very lightly on her eyelids. Now I'll be starting with the eyebrows. The right way to determine a person's eyebrows, so most of the beauticians know, is you need to form a line going from here to here and extend it. And where it ends is from where the eyebrows should start. So for example, hypothetically, if there is a line, if I just place this brush and I join this point to the end of the nose going upwards to the corner of the eye, so I get a starting point from where eyebrows should start. So she has a little light eyebrow, so this is where I'll start. So I need to build up her eyebrow. And similarly, when you join the outer corner of the lips to the corner of your eyes and extend the line, and that's where the eyebrow should end. So even when you're going through the parlor to get your own eyebrows done, or someone is coming and they have very thick eyebrows and you can't understand from where to start and where to end, this is the best way to determine. And if it's done that way, it frames the eye very well. And to determine the arc, she doesn't have an arc. But if you want someone who's got thick eyebrows and you want to create an arc, when you join this line to the middle of her eyeball, if she's closed, and you just go like this, this is where her arc should be. This is darkening her eyebrows, and I'm using a dark brown eyebrow powder. You can also use a matte eyeshadow if you don't have an eyebrow powder. But never use black, because black adds harshness to the face and it makes it look artificial. So I'm using this tan brown color.
So eyebrow pencil vandu romba common place. I'm sure bigger saloons and you know professionals like you would know how eyebrow pencils are used. But Aisha enna solranga black eyebrow pencil vandu appadi romba harsha kamikum. We've all seen chinna pas kuzhandha irukla pathinga black pencils are you know stand out. So what she's suggesting is that in the MAC oda illa different brands oda powder kedaikum brown eyebrow powder. So avangaloda ipo thin eyebrows ah irundha pathinga na and the powder use panni adha innum konjam enhance panni it looks a lot more healthier and lot more voluminous.
And when you're doing the eyebrow, you use an angular eyebrow brush which is flat out here and has an angle, and you don't make a line, you go in strokes in the direction of your hairline. So it doesn't look as if you, it looks natural, like her hair is straight going like this and then it goes corner. So I use the same strokes, small strokes like that. So I'll make small dashes and I'll